Hello again, everyone. Welcome to another doodle. This is number 4. This is doodle number 4. And I think today we're going to be more ambitious than we were, than we have been. I think today we're going to need to do pencil again. What a world. Now let's hope this pencil isn't broken. That's nice. My sharp bugger. There we go. That's very good. And I think today I'm going to draw people fighting over loo roll. Yep, I think that's going to be what I'm going to draw. And I'm going to try and make it... And bearing in mind, I've set myself a time limit for this, so this is, you know... I'm going to try and make it look a bit Renaissance. I'm just going to look up... Renaissance golden ratio. There's that little spiral that people draw on sort of football pictures and things that accidentally look like Renaissance art. So let's see if we can do that and have a bit of fun, for God's sake. Why wouldn't we? Got a nice metal ruler here, so maybe that would be useful to have. Just get the picture up on my laptop here. Picture of the old spiral. And yeah, okay. I'm not quite sure that this is the sort of thing that people generally freehand. But let's make it up. Let's tell ourselves we're doing Renaissance art. Even though what we're really doing is messing about. So we'll do a line here, and then it looks like we need another line. Looks like a sort of two-thirds kind of thing. We're just being vague with it. We're being vague, boys. And then another one down here. Okay, starting to make a certain amount of sense. It is, after all, a ratio. Horatio. Okay, I'm starting to see the pattern here. Are you? It's probably more than small enough for us. For our purposes. So what does it sort of come out like this? So it goes around up to here, and then all the way to the corner. That seems to be the key. All the way out to the corner, and then around to this corner. Well, it's not the most beautiful thing any of us have ever seen, but nothing is, so that's fine. Let's get interesting. Let's do it. Okay. Let's see. Yes. Now, what does the ratio mean? I don't know. I have no idea. But it will be fun for us to find out. He said, full of assumptions. Right. Let's give this a hecking good go. So we want a sweep of action. So we probably want the loo roll to be. Do we want it to be in the center? I'm never sure on exactly what the little sections signify. It's all sort of made up. Let's see. What should we do? Let's make the loo roll here. We'll do a big triple pack of loo rolls. Something roughly like this. Let's make it. Let's do it so it's tearing open. So there's a bit of action here. So the packet is tearing open here, and the loo rolls are falling out. Yeah, there we go. And maybe they're coming a bit undone. And the thing with, if you're drawing anything curved, always try and make sure the curves follow each other. And the line between these two points here should be different to imply perspective. If it's flat, then that means that it's actually at a weird angle, and that's not realistic. And we're going to be Renaissance artists, so we love realism now. That's the sort of thing we go in for, because we're really geniuses. So incredible geniuses here. Maybe we should make that even longer. Or maybe like the packet's being torn here by another. Do a hand here and a hand here. That's good. That's nice. So then the hand is probably about this long, isn't it? Do a hand here, and that's probably. Do little circles for the wrist joints. That helps. Ideally for all the joints, but then so there's the elbow there. The elbow would probably be about there. Shoulder. And we're going to put a head roughly here. If you want to do a good head, you can do a circle and then the sort of jaw and the neck. So the shoulder should be higher up here. Because he's struggling. Let's make this actually like he's looking a bit higher up. See, I've changed the angle here. So we're going to rub that out so we don't get confused. And change the angle here. So now it's looking like the eyes would be here, roughly here. Maybe the eye would be further along. Do a nose, mouth, head, neck, jaw. Nice. I can see that now we're cooking. Sometimes it's good to just be spontaneous. Not when you're buying a car or getting insurance, but in this scenario, try and make it look as much like they're in a pack as possible as well. So the shapes are being seen through the packet. Maybe a thumb, fingers. And he'll be coming in from the side here, won't he? Leaping, they're leaping for it. Let's see. We could do someone here facing away. That's a little modernist and weird. The back of someone's head. And then the neck here. Nice big sort of circle for the chest. Looks a bit like Handsome Squidward from the back. We've all always dreamed of seeing Handsome Squidward. There's another shoulder here, nice straight line down the body. And what's the arm doing? Pointing, perhaps. Yeah, let's do the arm pointing. So it's turned in. Some foreshortening here. The arm looks shorter as it gets further away, so that's important. Nice pointing, big pointing finger. That's good. That's looking pretty dramatic. Nice. I'm pleased with this. I hope you can hear how smug I am. I hope you're all doing well out there, by the way. If you know anyone who thinks this would be good, I don't know if this counts as ASMR. At some point, I'm going to post to like a ASMR forum. And I'm going to say, hey guys, does this tickle your pickle? And it might. It might do. But it's hard to say. Now, what's happened to it? This is torn. We know that. So we should probably have another person grasping at it. And since the toilet roll is the main object here, we can sort of use hands would be sort of here. The hands are a good starting point for figuring out where the body of the person should be. So this, I want this to be sort of overarm. They're kind of leaning and jumping with it. Okay. And then this. Where are their shoulders, if this is what they're doing? It needs to be, but maybe that forearm is too long compared to that one. So unless this person is a giant, which they might be, we need to do some more foreshortening, don't we? That's good. That's a nice place for the shoulder. Try and rub out as we go so we don't get construction lines confused. So if we do that over here, their shoulder's probably here. So that's their other arm. We'll do their head here. Head and shoulders here. They're also having a tough time of it. Let's make them a bit fatter. So we'll do their belly. Big round belly. Everything comes from the belly. Because it's the sort of basis for their body, you know. Visually, I mean. Big hip joints as well. The heavier you are, the bigger your hip joints need to be. So that's always worth remembering. Some legs here in like a kind of sumo stance for fighting for loo roll. Nice, okay. And then maybe this guy's legs, his hips would be about here. You can see that, so maybe we'll do his legs coming in as well. Maybe his knee joint. It's getting nice and crowded. It's getting nice and crowded, and that's exactly what we want. What's going on in the middle here? I need to try and keep this all quite realistic. Probably another head is here. Probably another head is here. Make sure we... Now the hard part about keeping all of this in our heads is to fill in the ink in layers. So we do this guy first, then this person, then that person, then this person, to make sure that everything is blocking everything it should be blocking, because otherwise you end up with lines going through stuff and it's not the end of the world, but it makes life more difficult than it needs to be. So his eyes are probably hidden. Should they be hidden? They'll be just about here. Okay, and that's... could be reaching up himself. Okay. And the body, I think, is 7 heads tall, generally, to keep it in proportion. So that's another head here. 1, 2, 3. Yes, so that's his torso. Torso? Yeah, somewhere around here. A bit wider. So hip joint here. There. And his arm is going to be sort of implied to be reaching as well, but we won't really see that very much. If we get rid of this line now, because we've got the construction, so we don't need to worry so much about our completely made up Renaissance ratio, do we? No, we don't. So we can get them to stop confusing us now, which is good. Don't need to be confused. Okay. That's nice. Yep. When you're drawing, your mind automatically looks at the boldest lines for instruction, I find. So it's always good to make sure that any bold lines that aren't absolutely bang on aren't there. And this is going to be messy. I know it looks very precise so far, but we have to to accept that it's going to get messy, just like it's getting messy in this actual scenario we've cooked up here. Let's see. Certainly raise the stakes for myself here. Deary me. Let's see if I can earn it, as it were. Okay, so there, he's there. What's happening with line the loo roll? Maybe we could do it really dark, like a Dutch Masters. So the loo roll is like glowing. So let's put a kind of glow line around it, like a holy object. That could be quite funny. Make that head a bit bigger there. And then the darkness will cover a multitude of sins. God, this is gonna take a while. Okay, let's see if we can meet our hour deadline. Well, not that it's a deadline. And to be honest, if it takes longer, it takes longer. Let's not stress ourselves out. Have an enjoyable time. Right, so I reckon that handsome Squidward over here is gonna be bald. I reckon he's a tough-looking bald guy from behind, because I think it would look cooler for him to be bald from behind than... Oh, someone's at the door. One second. Oh, back. Sorry about that. Okay. It wasn't for me. It was someone with the same sort of number address, but a different building, which happens a lot, actually. And it's quite annoying, because I would rather not be distracted from this beautiful Renaissance art that we're doing. Okay, so bald, handsome Squidward is bald. We can all agree on that. Okay, so big old bald head. Come on, pen, play ball. Okay. I gotta make sure the ears are represented. That's not a great ear, but it's okay. It's not a great ear. No one's gonna put it in their top 10 ears of the year, but that's all right. People have that weird thing where they... It looks kind of jawless now. We haven't done that very well. By which I mean I haven't done it very well, but that's all right. So quick. It's a sketch. It's a sketch. We've given ourselves some high Renaissance standards that we were never going to meet, just for fun. And it's just going to be a fun sketch. So we're going to do the end of the arm with an over arc there for, let's make it some kind of, come on, let's make it some kind of bracelet, actually. What happens to someone's arm when they point? There's a kind of... What kind of clothes is this guy wearing? It's even wearing a vest. He's a dangerous thug, this guy. He's wearing some kind of vest here. Now, sometimes it's useful to hold your own hand up to see what it would look like if you pointed like that. If you are not as good as you should be at anatomy. I suppose if I did this more, I would gradually begin to remember what things should look like. I certainly hope so. Right, now then. This hand is too big, I can see now. So let's make it smaller. Well, let's do the big bum first. There we go. Nice big bum and legs. You see the circle helps us with the angles of clothing. See that circle's round, so we should go over it like that, like we're going round a ball. So let's do that, my big pants. And there's some big bum cheeks there. The back of our knee. And let's do the shirt, whatever it is, the top is riding up. Definitely riding up. Okay. Now the head should really be done now. Because this is going to be crinkling into perspective, so we should not draw it as if they're standing up straight, because they're not. We can see they're not. What kind of hair would this person have? Let's just give them a kind of mop top. Big ringlets. Looks like their brain's fallen out. That's okay. All of our brains fall out sometimes. And in a way, their brain has fallen out because they are sort of looting, aren't they? The shoulder would be creating something of an imposition around here. There we are. There we go. A line there. Draw here. Yeah, no, I'm flattening the angle because, as I hope you can see, it needs to be a lot shorter than we've planned for. So it's going to be sort of grasping. Arms a bit thin. There we go. We can be messy. We can be messy. So, that's a bit too much ink there. We don't want to blob at this point. Now, you've got to, in your heart, you've got to welcome the blobs, but that doesn't mean we can invite them in so soon. If we can avoid the blobs, we should, at this early stage. And again, maybe earlier is better for the blobs so they can be incorporated and welcomed into the community. It's hard to say sometimes with blobs. So this elbow's here, so this one could be a little higher up, because it's slightly closer to us, but not too much higher up. Mm-hmm. So that's the elbow joint, so the wrist should start here. Come on, Pam. There we go. Nice. Okay. That's good. And then we're going to do the hands. Now this is going to be tough because they're sort of grasping in a way that's a bit hard to do now, aren't they? Well, we know the thumb would be here. So that's something. We can start with the base of the gripping thumb. Let's make a grabbing the loo roll. There we go. It goes around like that. That's a knuckle. Big knuckle, small knuckle. Well, she's got massive boxer's hands. That's okay. Maybe she's just lucky and has huge hands. Doesn't even have to be a lady. It could be anyone. Although it looks more like a lady than anything else. These bigger arms. It's just kind of grabbing. When we're grabbing, it looks like the middle finger's the most prominent, doesn't it? So we'll do a kind of in and up and around. And this sort of ring finger there. That's a fun, horrible finger. Grabbing. Let's do long nails. Horrible long nails. Now she wants that loo roll. And who can blame her? There's obviously none left. I'm joking, of course. There's loads left. Please do not panic buy on account of this silly drawing. Okie dokie. Right. Now we want this fella. This fella's got to get in the game. So that's like that. Okay. I'm trying to grip the loo roll there with the top of his hand. Slightly odd-shaped hands, but that's all right. Maybe that's just how his hands look. Who are you to judge? Give him a watch. Just to make it interesting. He's got a nice wristwatch there. I've never been much of a wristwatch guy. Some people love those things. Where did his elbows crook be? His McKenzie elbow crook. Where does Mackenzie be? He kind of be there. Let's make him a bit strong looking. Well, we've kind of broken our own rule here. Let's give him a t-shirt before we compound our errors. If you want to do wrinkles in fabric, doing a loop-de-loop like that can often make it look more like a wrinkle than if you did lines. Let's make his t-shirt a bit flappy. And then we do the knee of his jeans. Probably go down like that. And a bit of wrinkling there, a few loop-de-loos. Nice, we should be pleased with ourselves, I think. We're doing all right, it's all coming together. Look at these monstrous looters. Now we get into the face, and this is going to be important because this guy's face is the only really clear face in this thing. We've done a lot of cheating, really, a lot of obscuring of horrible faces, and we want it to be a sort of face of rage, don't we? Let's do the nose, because he's furious about not having any of the loo roll. Do a loop-de-loo for the nostril. There we go. And this is sort of where the brow comes in, so let's make him absolutely furious. He's snarling. How do you do a snarl? People kind of do their lips up in a kind of really odd way, don't they, when they snarl? There we go. That's kind of a snarl, isn't it? We can do the teeth going around the other side. How horrible is that? His tongue. His horrid tongue. We've accidentally given him a sort of mustache. which we're going to use to cover the sin of how badly we've drawn that upper lip. See, there's always a way out. There's always a cheat. You can always just say, no, it's a metaphor. I meant to do that. And a snarl looks good on someone with a mustache, I've always thought. If I had just a mustache, I'd snarl a lot more, I think. Just to make the most of it. Do the lid of the eye. First. This is a horrible looking man. I wouldn't trust him at all. Now the hair is always a real swine to do. We're going to do the lip as well. Lower lip. Come on, pen. Now's not the time to fiddle with us. Some little dots there for the tongue. That's nice. Do some shading for the inside of the mouth. Just single line hatching. I think that's called hatching, because I'm pretty sure cross-hatching is when you actually cross-hatch. And a nice chin. And the ear would actually be here, based on what we've done. There we go. And his neck is here. The t-shirt collar happening here. Big old neck, this guy. He's strong. I think he's going to get the loo roll. I'm going to try and do hair. I hate doing hair because I get a sort of slight deficit of attention, shall we say, when it comes to hair. Because it's just lots of scratching around, and if you scratch in the wrong order, it looks all wrong. So it really punishes you. Now you see the circle we did for the head is really helping us make sure that we've got the right kind of lines for the hair, or the right limit, you know, too high or too low. The hair kind of grows from that spot there, doesn't it? So he's got kind of lanky hair, this guy. He needs a haircut. But then again, we're all going to need haircuts after being in quarantine. People who watch this long after all of this is over, it's going to have a real sort of like fictional, that looks too much like a wig. It's going to have a real sort of fictional vibe to it, won't it? Where people will be like, oh, he does these videos where he pretends that there's been an apocalypse and he's stuck inside. Maybe the hair should be more wild. Got a kind of mullet thing happening now. Yeah, I've kind of salvaged that a bit. It's okay. No one would nominate it for Hair of the Year. But that's okay. A kind of eyebrow there. Right, his other hand now, as we work our way backwards through the perspective. The thumb would kind of be coming across to grip. What does that look like there? Sorry for blocking the view, everyone. Almost up from its mooring. It's a long old thumb. Maybe he's very evolved. Doesn't look very evolved though, does he? Careful that we don't back around the perspective on the hand here. Kind of have a bit there. That finger here is way too big. but that's all right. There we go. I suppose his other leg would also be sort of there. He's kind of squat grabbing. Maybe that's a bit too much. It doesn't look quite so balanced, but that's all right. We're just adding in detail. Now, who is this? This is the figure that people will study, the hidden figure at the back. It should be like an old lady or something. What would an old lady's hair look like? Probably in a bun? Yeah, probably in a bun. So let's try and do hair in a bun. Right, we're using the circle as a guide here, remember. So we might just about see the bun. Some of the hair from our perspective here. And an ear. Some of the hair here. I needed to have a thin old face and a sort of old lady's chin there. Do the ear here and no real eyebrows. She is the one being deprived of loo roll. That's what people will realize. When they write big essays on this incredible artwork we've done. What would an old lady sort of wear? Have an old lady's neck here. Skinny neck because she's old. It's a bit too skinny, but that's all right. Maybe it's a sort of old lady's necklace. There we go. And a sort of cardigan, maybe. Give her a sort of old lady's belt. Looks a bit like a bat belt. Give her a sort of old lady's dress. Oh, I've got some sort of wrinkles in. When I was growing up, after we moved to the Isle of Man, which is where I grew up, if you didn't know. I'm sure you did if you've ever seen my stand-up. I always have to explain it. There was a lady down the road who we used to call Lady Farmer. And I think it was her nickname because she had like really posh manners and things. She was a nice old lady. We lived in like a suburban estate, like generic, you know, housing for people. It's nice. So sort of old lady boobs. Something like that. It was nice, and Lady Farmer, she was very old fashioned, and she said women should only wear trousers on the riverbank. How about that? Isn't that amazing? I think that's a fantastic thing for someone to be able to say with total conviction. She wasn't like a, you know, ridiculously traditional in the sense that, you know, she wasn't like against female suffrage or something. But she felt that ladies should wear dresses. And fair enough, I don't have any dog in that fight. Wear what you like. frankly. Wear what you like, do what you like, within reason. Okay, we're doing the loo roll here now, so we want this to be... We want to have a feeling of action to it, I think. Maybe make this go a bit further down than it did. Take up a bit more space, because we're being lazy. Right. This one should probably have priority. This loo roll. Obviously they're all squeezed in together, but... I need to prioritize some of the perspective here. Okay. There you go, that's way too big. It's just bad quality loo roll. Let's suggest the paper. We shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have done that because the lines of loo roll when it's wrapped up are so fine that there's no need to depict them. You can leave them, but you know, in for a penny and all that. Oh well, that's fine. That's fine. So this is, should be exposed by the thing tearing. Let's do some jagged packaging here to suggest more tearing. Yeah, this should be more... grab, shouldn't it? There should be some more grabbing feeling going on. I'm trying to compensate. I should have drawn this in, taking the hand into account. Sort of wrinkles. As you're sort of grabbing the loo roll there. But you know, you can't have everything in life. There just wouldn't be room. And we're going to keep that pencil, that glowing line, because that's going to be for light and shade. And so we don't need to draw it in with lines, because that would defeat the object of what we're trying to do. And so, bearing that in mind, I'm going to paint a lot of the background bit here. I'm going to paint it in black around these edges. So if you imagine, that's the bright light, and then it's going to get progressively darker. So by the time we reach here, it should kind of just be black. And that is also another good way to save on having to sit and draw the flipping background. And we like saving time, especially when it saves time on the background, because the background is the least exciting part to draw. And maybe the most important for perspective, which is a real shame, isn't it? In an ideal world, the boring old background wouldn't be able to make us look either brilliant or very silly. But my God, it does. The devil is in the details. There we go. It's nice. Slowly filling it in. Just letting the ink leave the brush without going too crazy with it. Nice, okay. Might not seem like it, but this ink is so thick. Even though this ink is so thick, you can still, when you're coloring in with it as decisively as this, you can still get some patches that are lighter than others. Especially if you introduce any water at all, so we're going to try not to do that. And you don't have to dip the brush straight in. You can often get all the ink you need from the side of the bottle. Dipping straight in would be a bit of a waste. In terms of brushes, I'm not using, shall we say, the finest brushes in the land. So forgive. Forgive and forget. The best brushes I've used before have been maybe squirrel hair. Or maybe horse hair if it's a big old thing. But, yeah, a fine squirrel hair brush. Now that. Now that's a brush. That'd be a fun character. Kind of old-timey, tough guy. But it's just about art supplies. So let's actually draw in these lines. So that's going to be the glow line. And then this is the half light line. And then maybe we should go dark up to here, because then that takes in this bit. Let's do that then. Invisible curves, everyone. Okay, let's get all the dark, gloopy ink where we want it. It's a bit like painting the wall in your house. You should sort of just do the middle first and then use what's in the middle and do the edges. Well, that's not like the house, but you know what I mean, detailing and all that. Now I'm doing it just shy of the line, so it's going to be really hard to get any kind of blend. Probably going to have to do the colors first, because nothing, apart from maybe that new material, Vanta Black, is actually black. Things are black, but they will always reflect light to an extent. And there's very few things that are completely black in nature, which is why Vanta Black looks so weird. I encourage you to Google image search it. And so once we have a drawing which has black in, the color palette adjusts before our very eyes and becomes unrealistic. It's one of the unrealistic things about cartoons, is that in real life people don't have outlines. They just are. Corner there very carefully. Make it a bit rough up here. Sometimes instead of picking it out, you can do a sort of a brush past, and as you brush past a little bit there, I just pressed a little harder and it expanded the footprint of the brush. Like that. There we go. What a bit of mess there at the end. Keep me humble. Okay. All right, nice. Okay. And this is going to be black, which is going to be a bit confusing with the hair, but that's okay. Look like he's a horrible ghoul leaping from the dark, and in a way, it's exactly what this guy is. Mm-hmm. Bum, 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 bum. Okay, so that's pretty much it. We're going to keep the lines here because the colors on the people will need to be darker as well as a result. So let's bear that in mind. Right. Now, I reckon that the coloring in the background, I'm going to want it to go from black to brown to tan to golden around the loo roll. The loo roll is going to be absolutely golden. That's what we want. I think if I use this to do a wash, maybe that's the right sort of idea. So that no matter what color... see, I'm not going to be able to rub this out. It's too late. Okay. Oh well. Oh well, we accept the hand we are dealt in life. There's not much other choice. Okay, so I'm going to fill this in. This is a bit lazy. That's all right. We're allowed to be as lazy as we want. Okay. Lovely. Lovely pants there. Now, I think it's time, everyone. I'm going to take a little break so that this can dry. And I'm going to make a coffee. I'll be back in literally, from your point of view, 1 second. Okay. It is dry now. So now what we do, everyone, is we erase our old friend, the pencil lines. I'm taking care, because even when it seems dry, I shouldn't have actually erased that one. That's one of the useful ones. I'll remember it. No, I'll do it back in. Even when some of the ink seems dry, with enough force, such as the kind of force one might use when rubbing something out, can be enough to dislodge a bit of ink that the surface of which is dry, but there's just a little tiny sneakeroony bit of ink in there somewhere. So that's good. Hope this isn't shaking too much. Make sure we don't erase the next lovely shading line, which is here. Now we get a much clearer look at this guy's face, because we had so many planning lines here. And, always remember to rub out bits like the hair there, because there'll be little bits of pencil hiding in there, being sneaky, ready to ambush us when we try and colour in. With his hair, it won't be much of a problem, because the hair will be dark in colour, and it might even, help a little. But in case you're doing your own art and you think he should somehow be blonde, then that is something to keep a little eye out for, my sweet and dear friends. Is the pencil going to leave this woman's bum? No, it's not. But we knew that when we made the mistake. We've accepted that now. We've processed it, and we have accepted it. Guy's arm's got some pencil ruler lines in. That's no good at all. Lines you draw with a ruler always seem much, much harder to erase than any other. I don't know if that is a metaphor for something, but why not leave a comment underneath? If you like the video, do leave a comment, because I think the more comments you guys leave, the more people will see the video. I would assume so. And why not help people see this nice video instead of a video that will politically radicalize them in a direction that perhaps no one finds helpful? Let's see. Okay. Right. That's looking pretty legitimate now. It's funny, the more you erase, the more you see the ones you've missed. The little scribbly, scrobbly lines that you miss out. Okay, this guy's an absolute forest of lines. Right. Now then, okie dokie. What do we do now? I suppose we start colouring in. I suppose that's the world we live in. Now remember, we want these colours to be darker versions of the colours they are as we go in. And that is a big ask, but maybe we'll do it. Maybe we'll manage it. Wouldn't that be incredible? Won't we be able to walk around like Smuggy McSmuggington, if that's the kind of thing that we can pull off here? Right. So these clothes, all being in shadow, they all need at least one layer of the same wash we've done on the lady's bum. At least. Roughly that kind of line. The wetter you make it, the easier it will be to complete the sweep before you start running over your own lines and creating darker lines where perhaps you didn't want them. So speed can be of the essence when it comes to this sort of thing, I'm afraid. Something to bear in mind. There we go. Okay, we are in business. I used to do a lot more pen and ink brush work than I do now. So this is nice. This is nostalgic for me. And I hope it holds some faint value for you. That would be a nice thought. You're getting something out of this ridiculousness as well. Okay, get these pants darker. Yes, sir. I'm focusing in on these pants because, and this should be in shadow because it's even further back, as should this. I'm focusing in on the pants a little bit because that should be darker as well. Because I think those pants are actually going to be dark grey in the real world, as it were. As opposed to just in this thing we're doing. So, as a result, they need to be shaded in more. Sure, we're all on board with the perspective. Would I say this is going perfectly? No. Not quite perfectly, no. That's okay. That's okay, she can have a mottled old bum. Many people do. Many people do, I find. I think that's probably dark enough, for our purposes, for now at least. So let's do some colours. I reckon this guy's vest is white, it's a classic white vest. So I reckon that's going to be a bit of shadow there. White old vest, and he's gonna have some stubble, isn't he? Oh. Very diluted grey water can be quite good for stubble, actually. A bit more like a haircut. An error. Do some dots here for the shading. There we go. That's the sort of thing that we want. Put a shadow in there. Yeah, that's all right. It'll do. It'll do for our purposes, at least. Yeah, that's some kind of hair. He said, reassuring himself. Yeah. Alright. Okay. I'm happy enough with that. Let's see. I'm afraid to say that this lady should be a bit washed out as well, given how far in the background she is. So let's just do that, shall we? She has her own rules, this lady. The ghost at the feast. That's what she is. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, nice. Happy, happy. Happy times. Bit of shadow in there. Oh, that's way too much. Bit of shadow in there. Bit of shadow in there. Definitely some shadow in his open yelling mouth. That's exactly where shadow lives, in the yelling mouths of looters. That's where shadow lives, all right. There we go. Mm-hmm. A little bit of shadow there. Bit of shadow here. Definitely some shadow here. Some shadows here. Will it come together? I hope you're as excited to see whether this works or not as I am. Okie dokie then. Bit of shadow there, why not? A little bit there. And a little bit there. And what the theory is, everyone. The theory that we are operating under here, everyone, is that this will all seem very wonderful, and it will shine through. God, that's not working at all. Dilute, dilute, dilute. Oh, no. Let's get the paper. Let's get the emergency paper out here. It's helped a little bit. Not much. Oh, well. The theory is that as we add the color, it will show through the black, I mean, or the gray, rather. The Indian ink will show through. Because remember, it doesn't run, and that goes for when you dilute it as well. That's the real magic power. So you can do this kind of shading. So slightly cheeky. Now, where would the shadow be here? The shadows inside a tube are a smaller version of the tube itself, but you don't do the rest of it because that's the perspective here. You do two circles and you make sure the other bit of the circle is invisible, like it should be here. Nice, that's got a bit of 3D-ness. And of course there's shadows of the paper being torn and attacked by these savages. To be fair, I haven't seen anything this bad on the news here. In the UK, at least. So that's to our credit, barely. But everyone's still going to pubs and stuff, which is ridiculous. There we go. Okay, now then. Now then, what are we doing? We should get an eye bag. There we go. Horrible. Yes. A little bit more shading. But we must know when to stop. That is the hard part, to be honest with you guys. Knowing when to give it a flipping rest. Okay, that's looking nice. We didn't rub out the feed line for the light, but that's okay. We can get away with that. We can. If you don't tell anyone, I won't tell anyone either. So that's nice. Right. Next stage. Skin colors. We need some skin colors. What skin colors are we gonna choose? What kind of skin color are you? Is it more or less politically correct if I make this a multiracial horrible mob? Because it's not a bunch of sympathetic characters, you know. I suppose I should make it for everyone. Everyone being a horrible monster. Because then it's like, see, we're all alike. Who was that guy who got in trouble for doing a caricature that people said was racist? Well, there's been a few. Main thing to remember that is that a lot of newspaper caricatures are quite bad, he said, not proving himself any better with his stupid art. How did some black ink get into that nice colourful ink when we have been so very careful with ourselves? I don't know. I honestly couldn't tell you. I thought we'd been very careful. See? There? It's always hiding at the base of the brush. Ready to leak out and ambush you. If we were being really proper, we would use different brushes, but we aren't being proper. We're being reckless and silly. Okay. Wow, that stuff really is not going away, is it? Maybe we should use a different brush. But what are our options? This is the kind of the king brush, in my opinion. Still kind of there. All right, let's try a different one. You're up, square guy. Now this will be a lot cruder because it's a worse brush. It's a worse brush, to be perfectly frank with you. Brown hair on the lady. Yeah. Much easier with a clean brush. Just doing the colors lightly at first. Because if we do them lightly, we can build up layers once we're ready to, without rushing. Without doing anything hasty, for God's sake. Bit of orange there. The orange is a bit lifeless, I think. It's a bit too red, the orange. So let's get some yellow in little bit of yellow. Make sure the water that's hiding on the metal bit goes away. How's that looking? It's a bit too yellow. But it puts a bit of health into the guy, you know? Makes him look a bit more alive. Who is this thuggish man? What are his priorities? I would say his priorities are the loo roll. Wouldn't you? Mm-hmm. Right. Oh, what color is this woman's top going to be? Or is she her skin? We need to do her skin, even though it's in this dark bit here. There we go. Oh, God, nearly did the dark ink dip. Gotta watch out for that. Okay. I don't know, Pierre. Everyone's looking pretty white so far. You know. I think I just kind of... Maybe I'm just not confident enough to expand it. I don't know, to be honest. I mean, it's an ugly scene. No one's going to come out of it looking well, are they? So I sort of... In my desperation to appeal to other people who consider themselves to be progressive, I am, in fact... failing at being truly unthinking in my approach, which I suppose is the goal. Now I'm just dotting this because she's supposed to have curly whirly hair, and so smooth filling in will only counteract that impression. So let's really bloody make it a bit of a contrast into this guy's weird pale hand. Why is it so pale? Because I have failed to make it not pale. For shadow reasons. Okay. Uh-huh. Shadow reasons. Like Shadow Chancellor. Sounds cooler than it is. Bum, 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 bum. Bum. Okay. 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 Now, this chap's definitely wearing jeans. We can all agree on that. So let's get some jean colouring going on here. Okay, make it a bit darker here. See, what's nice is you can ignore the barriers when you're dealing with this dark Indian ink because it just won't show up. So it hides a multitude of sins. Okay, we're overloading the paper a bit, but that's okay. Now, what color should his generic t-shirt be? It's not as easy to be as expressive with modern clothes. That's one advantage the Renaissance guys had. Not to make excuses, but I am. Let's make it a sort of red t-shirt of some kind. Coming through quite purple, so we'll do some yellow over the top. Make sure no one gets confused. Uh, And what are we going to do? Yellow. That's right. Don't lose your memory. Oh, sneaky bit of water there, trying to wreck our fun. Right now then. Ladies top. Ladies top. Light blue. I think. Okay. Oh, we all knew this would be complicated, but who knew it would be this complicated? Me, I knew. I basically knew the whole time. Because I could sense when I was getting a little overambitious. And this was one of those times, I think. Oh well. Such is life. I'm sure we will all survive. Right. Yes, let's just keep getting some color there so we can say it's there. That's the key. Do some more flesh coloring in on this honky. Let's say this scene is in Montana, where there are no minorities. I don't know. I can't stop talking about it. I know it would be less awkward if I just shut up, but I can't stop because I haven't planned this. It's just being all made up for good or for ill, everyone. And through the mustache there, and this guy, and the lid, so he doesn't look like a corpse. Boom, boom. Okay, get the other arm in here, that's nice. And that's another boundary we can overdo on the sleeve because it's the same kind of color, so it doesn't show up, that's nice. There's something not quite human about this light orange, and I'm struggling to figure out if it's the yellow or if it's the, maybe it's a lack of red. It's hard to say, you know. Oh, isn't life difficult? Okay. I will say doing the gray undershading makes it very drab. So bear that in mind. You won't get the kind of zippy colors that we've been seeing. You won't pop in quite the same way. There we go. His hair color can be a really dark brown for all we care. Not even black. There we go. I'll be a bit messy with it, so it's like, wow, look, that's definitely hair. I'll say it isn't. And eyebrows. I never forget the eyebrows. Even though I forgot to draw them in. There we go. That's a bit more full of life, isn't it? Now he's got a horrible brow. Is that, can that be brown? Yeah, why not? Okay. What are we doing? Mm-hmm. Sometimes you can think you're painting, adding to the drawing, and you're moving the brush really confidently, and then you hit a patch of white like that and realize you've been doing absolutely nothing. You were just like when a little kid doesn't realize their controller's not plugged in for the video game. That's you, that is. Right. The old lady's dress would be pink, I think. I think it would be pink. With, and you're going to say I'm crazy, blue flowers of some kind. Nope, that is too wet to do that, Pierre. You should have known. Now those are going to have to just be blue stripes. Right. Now, really dark shading. How are we doing for time? We are running on late now. Come on, Novelli. So this should be very dark brown, in my opinion. I might need a much bigger brush for this bit. And luckily, I have one. Okay, come on, big old brush. Come to the rescue. I think this is actually quite a nice brush. So let's be respectful. Let's be respectful of this giant brush. There we go. Luckily his hair is brown, so we don't have to worry too much about completely messing it up. Nice, yep, dark old brown. Bit of mess there, that's okay. This is gonna be messy. Be careful there, there we go, that's nice. We're not getting too crazy. Gotta fill in these gaps. Okay, I'm trying to do some big old like gap filling bits just to make this a little faster. And if you dilute it like that, you get a much thicker, darker color much faster. And that's what we want. That's what we want marked out. I'm going to overlay the brown here so that it doesn't look too different. That might help it actually. I might smooth it out a bit. Do it with my finger to be cheeky. There we go. And this guy here. And this guy here. Oh. Okay, we need a smaller brush now. There's no getting around it, everyone. There comes a time where we just have to admit that we need a smaller brush. Although, I would like to imply that the loo roll is in a packet. You can see it's in a packet, but we need to imply it with the color. The color has to play a part in this. And I think that this blue is the way to do that. looking at the wonderful white loo roll through the blue plastic. Or at least that's the idea. Okay, yeah. Right. Now we need to go back to our old friend, the dirty brush from before. Like a good play, there's a whole structure to this. Villains and heroes. It's still dirty. How? How are you doing this to me? There we go. Is that better? No. What has happened to you, brush? We try, and yet. Okay, so. Now for some of the fine brown work. Not the brown fine work, but the fine brown work. Okay. Right. Now we're gonna find some color overlap here. And it's important not to just go too crazy about accuracy. Because where's the fun in that? We want to be a little reckless here and there, don't we? I know I do, because it makes my life easier. Okay, that's all right. Now let's do these guys. That a bit. Yeah, don't want that on my wrist. Again, we're being a little reckless with the order in which we're doing this, but that's fine. What I mean is you should always work from the top left-hand corner this way if you are right-handed, because then you won't smudge anything. But then that can conflict with the layering. There can be contradictions. It's all about compromise and figuring it out. And it can be very tricky. Never panic. And we're not being too careful, because you know what? It's not like this is for anything other than to amuse us. / me. I don't know what you're getting out of it. It could be anything. I hope you're getting something, because otherwise this just seems insane. Okay, yeah, and this should be darker here. There we go. Try and make that a bit more of a fade. Okay, try and make this a bit more of a fade. It's not quite watery enough, is it? I'm being reckless here. I'm not giving it enough time. But that's all right. Here we go. Right, now. A late reappearance for our old friend, the rubber. Or the eraser, if you're American. There we go. That's something. That's a bit of help. Right. Now, that blue needs to be emphasized a little. For the sake of this packet here. It's a bit too wet. There we go. hopefully it's clear that this is supposed to be a sort of blue plastic bag around the lure. Is it clear? It's hard to say. Well, it better be bloody clear now. Right. What on earth are we doing? We are maybe doing a bit of shadow. There. Yep. Darkening that. Okay. Some details, he said. This guy needs to look a bit less dead, I think. I think that's fair to say. Well, that's not less dead, is it? It's something. It's something. Right. Still there's some black ink left in this thing. Wow. It is stubborn, this stuff. Let's get some yellow. A bit dirty. Oh no. Lord save me from grubby yellow. Okay. That'll do. There's a bit of detail there. Let's imply that this is a chain. That would look better. There we go. Oh, we need this guy to have some different. Now, if you want to do really small detail, you need something called a rigging brush. That's the real deal. It's called that because it's so small that they used to use it to do the rigging on paintings of ships. Of course. If we're dealing with rigging, we're dealing with ships, aren't we? He's wearing lipstick. There we go, that's nice, okay. Let's make him a green-eyed devil. That's not a green eye, it's hazel. Oh well, it's something. Something for the kids. What does that mean? I don't know. Okay. Bit of a shadow there. Yeah, okay. Yeah, there's some life lacking in this, isn't there? Something missing. Something missing! Right, and we need some clean. Oh, I should close this ink. Naughty. Right, shut this. Now we need some clean yellow. Really clean. Not this grubby nonsense that we've been putting up with. Maybe this will work. Yeah, there you go. That's something. Not consistent though, so we don't trust it. We go back to the old big boy. There we go. We do this wonderful glow. You have to say glow up for makeover, don't you? I'm old. I don't know the words. To be fair, I didn't know any of the cool words when I was young, really. So, if anything, I'm the consistent one. Lovely glowing golden. Like the thing from Pulp Fiction, this toilet roll. The ultimate prize. You can see why they're fighting over it. And you see it's starting to blend now. It's looking a bit less silly. It was looking a little silly before. I'll admit it. You know what? Hey, I will admit that. That it was looking a little silly before. Look at them go! Look at that. There we go. It's kind of thing you want to see. What else are we doing here? The old lady, she's haunting us. Not in the right way. She needs to be shaded in. I'm going to re-blacken everything in aid of exactly that. Yep. Okay, this is nice and clear. Here we go. A bit more shadow there. And some dark blue shadow in general here. Go. Is that shadow obvious enough on this chap with his white vest? Maybe not. I'm gonna follow that line. I can't really get any darker, can it? Oh well, let's do some black watercolor instead of Indian ink on the lady, the old lady's cardigan, which I think is a black cardi. A cardigan black, a cardi B. I don't really know who or what cardi B is. Because I am cool. Very cool. How cool. Very. That's how cool I am. I know she's an artist of some kind, a recording artist. And I have a sense memory that she's controversial in a way that I can't really remember. But that's the best I can do for you, I'm afraid. So, what are we doing here? Give him a watch strap. There we are. Sometimes you just get these little dots of lightness that you must do your best to eliminate. They do make it look messy. The yellow. We were being good yellow people. Let's see if we can get some non-dirty yellow by just trying to use the tip of the brush instead of relying on the whole thing to feed. There we go. That's good. Although we want kind of whiteness to imply glow, don't we, really? So we should get a very thin yellow. Oh, it's grubby again. Come along. Sorry to expose you to the stress of this grubby yellow. Should we do a sort of yellow glow on their horrible faces? Maybe. I'll do that with a different brush. For now, I need to be a little darker on this lural shading. That's better. That's more convincing, in as much as we're trying to convince anyone of anything. There we go. Water there. Sneaky, sneaky. Never trust a brush. That's what they say. Yeah. And make sure people realize that this is the real deal, Lural. Okay. There's a bit of yellow there. You can see it's missing it. That's something, isn't it? We've definitely made something, and that's all we really set out to do. Sorry for crackling my fingers a little there. People hate that sometimes. You see how much lighter this has dried than we thought before. It was ever so dark before. But it's all ended up a lot lighter than we thought. And let's hope that that is what's going to happen in our lives. Bum, ba, bum. Mm-hmm. Ba, 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 ba. I'll blur that in a bit, make it less obvious what we were up to. Right. Yeah. That's something. Should do some more shading on the old there. Maybe this is the right sort of color. That's a bit too dark. I really must use this mixing bit more. Try and get rid of all the excess moisture before we go in there. There we go. Life into these. That's quite Quentin Blake, these hands, this one here. He said, tooting his own horn. But still, I think it's a legitimate observation. Mm-hmm. There we go. They're missing a bit of colour. He just looks a bit Australian or something, maybe. Have they been fighting over Lural? I have, a sense memory of the news that maybe they have. I should be in the Melbourne Comedy Festival right now. Anyone watching in Melbourne, I'm very sorry I can't be there. I would love to be there. I would much rather be wandering around your city, having brunch three times a day than sitting and painting insane things. Not that this is not fun for me, it is. But, you know, we all had life plans, didn't we, before the plague struck. Well, let's do some golden highlights. Like there's a golden. Does that make any sense visually? No, it doesn't really. Shouldn't really have done it. But it's too late now. We've done it. It's Let's make it look like it's glowing, like actual shiny gold. Like a shininess on his hands. I'm trying to pretend as if it's like a light bulb glowing. I hope that's coming across. Probably won't come across visually, but we must do our best to try now that we've committed. It's too late now, we've committed. Oh dear. Keep this yellow clean. It's impossible. It is so difficult. No, no, no. And it should be almost a yellow hand, I guess, from the glow. Go. I like to think that that's worked. A little. Not loads, but a little. Okay, and a bit of darkness here on the back of her head. Oh, that's too dense. There we go. Make it a bit darker. That is in shadow by comparison. We all agreed that to follow the shadow plan. Which sounds pretty cool. Yep, okay, and then some slightly darker skin. Yeah, ooh, oh, she's really screwed up the fake tan there. And let's do a couple of details, shall we? No, this has gone on for way too long. Okay, that's it. The drawing's done. It's completed. It's over. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'm amazed if you watched all the way through to the end. But thank you very much if you did. If you look at the link in the description, you can buy me a coffee or you can listen to the podcast I do with Phil Wang. Please do like and subscribe and send it to anyone who you think would enjoy it. These are the looters. Thank you very much.